The Wombats are sneaky. They make bright, fun, shimmering pop music about occasionally very serious things.
Please allow me to be your antidepressant.
And whether they're singing about antidepressant addiction, breakups, or long-distance relationships, one thing seems to be consistent. They always make people dance.
For you guys up on the stage, just put us in that headspace. Describe for us what it's like to look out on a room full of packed people. What goes through your head?
You're a bit anxious, but in a good way beforehand. And then once you get on there, like the best gig, so like Splendor the other day, it's almost like meditation or something where my brain is, there's not any other thoughts in my head. Splendor, honestly, was one of the best feelings that's out there on the market. It was, it was very special.
In that process of writing songs, walk me through how the Wombats make a song.
There's three different ways, I think, on this album. Either I would bring a song in and then play it on acoustic guitar, and then we'd build everything around it, or Dan and Todd would send me an idea and then we'd build on that. Or one song came from kind of just...
Jamming.
I hate that word, but messing around in a room. And one song came from that. If I think it's got a good song title, I'm happy to pursue it. If I don't, I'm kind of a bit reluctant.
That I guess like naming a baby, isn't it? It's like you give them the name before they develop a personality.
And they just grow into the name.
Yeah, they become the name.
That process of initially showing a name or lyrics to the other guys, is that ever a little bit anxious?
Yeah, it's awful.
No, it's normally because obviously like Murph writes from a very personal place, and it's often like something that we know has happened and you're almost expecting something to be about it. And then when it isn't, it's like obviously just putting his heart on his sleeve, and like obviously it takes a lot of courage for any songwriter to like speak from the heart and say like really what's going on in their head.
Do you ever pause? Do you ever go, actually, no, this is too personal, I don't necessarily want to share this?
I'm much more worried about what they think than what anyone else thinks, really.
Because it's
like when it's getting released, I'm like, oh, brilliant, fine, I don't really...
By that point, there's quite a lot of separation from the initial...
Exactly, yeah, well, you're not as fully attached to it, I guess.
Like looking at a photograph.
Yeah.
Sonic photograph. I think a lot of the time, you know, you spend so long making songs and stuff, and then it's really nice once you've poured all that, like, you know, creative energy into it and, like, worked tirelessly on it and poured your heart and soul into it and all the rest of it, and then playing it live is almost like that's you wanted all along, almost that moment of like sharing that with a load of people in a room. And yeah, you couldn't feel like morose, could you, at the time, almost on stage? You're just like, this is awesome.
When you're recording, how do you know when a song's done? Like when to stop fiddling with it?
Never.
When it comes out.
Yeah. Right.
When it comes out and you physically can't fiddle with it anymore.
Yeah.
Have there been tracks that you'd like to go back and go, I've just thought of a hook or something else to it?
Never.
Right.
For me, every time, yeah.
It's just nice when it's out and kind of like, okay, that's it. And kind of like you can't touch it, so and therefore it kind of leaves you with that kind of like peace of mind. That's kind of, yeah, that's the way it's supposed to be.
I think the whole thing about being in a band or being creative is you basically just trawl through mediocrity your entire life for these few sporadic moments of like really lovely, like this song is an amazing one. And generally most bands don't always have those songs. You know, they don't have 12 of them on an album. So I guess then you kind of turn into, I'm gonna take these ones that I personally think are okay and just try and make them into one of these magical twinkling little stars or whatever. So that's, I think, where the kind of perfectionist aspect comes from.